Good morning. This morning I got up a bit early. I went upstairs and my friend had put some onions in a tray. I don't know why, but months ago, and I took a picture before of the beginning of the leaves coming out of the onion, the sprouts, but the sprouts are now quite well developed coming out of the onion. I don't know what kind of part of the plant the edible onion is, but I think it's a stem, really, and there are roots coming out of the bottom of it. Anyway, I took a sample of the leaves coming out of the top of the plant, and I made it thin, cut it up, made usable slides, and to look at the cells. The interesting thing about this is what the microscope does. The high power on the microscope has a very narrow range of focus. So if you just use the open iris on the condenser, which has a very thin depth of field, the surface of the plant looks like, well, stone sometimes. It looks like bricks, and the craftsmen who put the bricks together fit them in wherever they could so that the bricks or the cells have different shapes and sizes depending on how they fit into the matrix, the wall of the leaf, and it's an interesting concept and an interesting thing to see. It looks like you're traveling through walking over a sidewalk or a path made out of stone, where the walls are made out of stone. But if you use the condenser, the iris, and you squeeze it down, you make it as small as possible so that the depth of field, the distance between that's within focus, the depth within focus of the microscope, it begins to look like the walls are made of glass or even gemstones. So the experience is quite different. You could see different levels within the cell, and you could see some of the features inside. There are organelles within these cells that's floating in the water that actually, or the material that actually comprises the cell. It's all liquid. And they float around in there, and not only that, but they carry information from one part of the cell to the other. So you vary when you look at the cells between bricks or stone, glass brick, and gemstones. And you could focus back and forth inside them. It's a beautiful concept, and the way that the microscope converts the surfaces that we see in a microscope from looking solid to looking transparent and liquidy even. I have samples of cells from this tiny piece of sprout, and I tried to get it as diverse as I could. Take a look.